have our edge row unit shown here with two airbags to give us our down pressure and use that to get the row unit into the ground. When we're mounted into a three-point application, we can mount this with a single airbag, but on a pull-type machine like we have here, we're gonna have dual airbags. That gives us additional force to make sure that we can get down to the depth that we wanna be running. Again, we're gonna be using our air regulator inside the cab to control the air pressure, and by regulating that pressure in these bags, that's gonna set the depth that the row unit wants to be running. The edge row unit does not have any grease zerks on the pivot points here. We have a special poly bushing that we're using inside of each of these pivots for the parallel arms and the containment arm, and that poly bushing is gonna give us the long service life that we expect, but you're not gonna be having to attend to it with the grease gun on a daily basis. In that same mindset where we're trying to minimize the amount of servicing that you're doing on a daily basis, the edge row unit's gonna be using an oil bath hub in the tillage coulter position here, lead coulter position here, and the containment coulter back here. All of these are an oil bath hub that's not gonna require any daily maintenance. This edge row unit's gonna have a 17-inch lead coulter in the front position, followed by a pair of 20-inch coulters back here. They're physically about 6 inches apart, but they're going to give you a zone that's up to about 10 inches wide and a depth of 5 to 6 inches deep to give you a nice tilled area where these coulters are cutting, mixing, and incorporating all of the fertilizer into that zone. As we move back towards the rear of the row unit, these large discs are the containment coulters. They're designed to contain and capture anything that's been loosened up as you head across the field. All that dirt and disruption that's been tilled up, we contain it with these discs and put it right back into place to give a nice built-up berm. On the back of the row unit, we have the optional rolling basket, as you would see here. This is gonna be mounted on a spring to give it some flexibility to follow the contour of the ground. This is our round bar rolling basket that gives you the versatility to run in a wide range of conditions. It's gonna do a nice job of crumbling up any clods that make it through, and it's also going to remove any air or excess air that's into that strip. Again, this is mounted onto a spring, but if you get into conditions where you don't want to be running it, we can raise it up and put it in the carry position to give you one more level of flexibility to make sure we're adjusting this row unit for the conditions that you're seeing out in the field. The edge row unit was designed to have the versatility to be running in either a coulter configuration, as you see here, or to have a shank mounted in its place. By taking out these four mounting bolts, this pair of tillage coulters can be removed and the shank mount will go in place right there. We can either have a shear bolt mounted shank or a hydraulic reset option to give you the ultimate amount of flexibility.